So as many of you know, I'm a big fan of dark Superman stories. I even wrote my own comic that featured a dark version of the Superman character. There are so many ways you can go with it. But what disappoints me, at least so far, with the Brightburn version, well, we'll talk about it not being from Warner Brothers in DC in just a moment, and maybe that's why it's so, I think, disrespectful. Because instead of their Superman, it seems just, you know, the reason Superman is such a nice guy in his actual main stories is that, of course, he embraces his human side because he doesn't know he's an alien until, you know, he hits puberty, basically, right? So he's already formed that identity as a human. But usually when he goes evil, it's because he focuses on the alien side, right? Why should he serve the people of Earth when they're so beneath him, et cetera, et cetera. And that's really, it's fascinating to think of the different paths. But here it seems, at least from the first trailer, we'll see if it's still the case, that this kid's just nuts, okay? He's just crazy. So it's like, what if a crazy person had Superman's powers? And I think that's, you know, not particularly interesting. I mean, it might be visually interesting. There might be some interesting, horrific horror action sequences here. But I think from a story point, it's a little lazy. You know, like, why is he bad? Because he's crazy, right? I mean, unless they can show what maybe made him lose his mind. I don't know. Let's take a look. It kills me that Warner Brothers DC isn't telling a dark Superman story because they've done such a good job so many times for someone else to get the credit with the general public, like, oh, very clever, James Gunn. It's like super annoying because so many other writers have thought of it. And I think, at least from what I'm seeing so far, done a better job. But let's take a look. I do like Superman, heat vision in the dark.
Mom?
Who am I?
You are a gift.
He's like, James Gunn is like, this is so awkward now that I work for Warner Brothers.
We believe DC. That you came here for a reason.
Oh.
I know it's been difficult for you lately, that you feel different from other kids.
Just the floor, Brian.
You are different.
Caitlin, get my hand up.
He's a creep.
Help him up.
Mm. What are you doing?
I want him in handcuffs and I want him gone.
Do you even know who his real mother is?
I'm his real mother. Let's go.
Maybe there is something wrong with Brandon.
I'd like to go to school now.
He's not my son.
Watch out, Aladdin.
Hey, this beats Aladdin. With me.
See, why is he doing that? Oh. What did she ever do to this kid? Oh, don't kill the lunch lady.
Something wrong?
Boy around by chance.
You're one of the only people in the world that knows how special I am.
There are believed to be no survivors among the 268 passengers on board.
Whatever you've done, I know there is good inside you.
I don't think so, Elizabeth Banks.
No, 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 you
nobody would do this who had any good inside.
I want to do good, Mom. I do.
Well, they always get me with the visual effects. I'm like, well, that flying through the kitchen was pretty cool. I think I'd like to see maybe what else they've got. But yeah, I mean, that poor lunch lady, it's so mean. You know, you ever heard of the saying? It's very popular. I heard it. It really stuck with me for some reason when I heard it on Justified. Such a good show. So anyway, Timothy Oliphant says, if everyone you meet is an asshole, maybe you should consider that the asshole is you. So at some point, someone would say, if everyone picks on you, from your fellow students to the lunch lady, maybe you're doing something weird. You ever thought about that? You know, maybe you're putting a weird vibe out there, right? And I think clearly, as you can see, he's not a nice person and there is something wrong with him. And also, I don't know how I feel about turning it into like, is that really why you shouldn't bully someone? They might be able to kill you, which is very tragically the case in some ways. That's really, I think, not the takeaway that should be there. They've made the character extremely unsympathetic. Obviously, you're supposed to really associate with Elizabeth Banks's character. I just think, to me, I told you, I feel it's lazy. You know, it's a horror story. It's just a horror story. And I don't know, she better find whatever their ripped-off version of Kryptonite is if she's going to survive this, because I don't see any other way to take him down. Or what their ripped-off version of Batman is, right? They're like, maybe in another city, like a big city nearby, there's some rich kid who's smart enough to figure out a way to defeat my bully. You know, he turned into the bully. I hope someone shouts that at him before he kills them. All right, so anyway, what do you think? As I said, you know, oh man, are we that easy? You know, I think as comic book fans, I gotta see what you got. I gotta see it. I gotta see what they have, but I'm not happy about it. All right, I guess the real question is if it's gonna make, you know, I think this is low budget enough that even if just as comic book fans go, it should do pretty well. Although they thought Overlord would do well, and that sure bombed. So, we'll see. Are you planning to see this in theaters? Share your thoughts down below. Thank you for watching with me. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.